Dubsado's custom map fields. What are they? How do you set them up? And how do you use them in your business? That's what we're covering in today's video. Well, hello there. My name is Ray, and this is the Productive Co. YouTube channel. This is the YouTube channel talking about all things Dubsado. In today's video, we're going over custom mapped fields. Now, before we get started, this video is part of the Dubsado Blueprint, a free 9-step download to help you get your Dubsado set up quickly. I'll make sure to link that down below so you can access it at any time. After you download the Dubsado Blueprint, make sure you subscribe to this YouTube channel so you can get more videos on how to use Dubsado in your business. Without further ado, let's dive into custom map fields. So before I jump into custom map fields, I first want to explain what mapped fields are. So Dubsado has a feature that they call question mapping. And what that does is it takes answers from questions and maps them to a different location. And Dubsado maps those answers to the client folder and the address book. Now I'm in my template section under forms, and I'm going to click on a lead capture. I'm going to collect certain information here, their first name, their last name, their email. And if I don't set up mapping, what will happen is this information will just live inside of a form. It won't add their name to the address book there. I have to tell the name where to go. So I do that with question mapping. So you can either use short answer or date select to do this. And I've got my first name here, and I'll click open this question. And I'm going to tell Dubsado to map the first name to the first name in the address book. So I can click this drop down here and I can select where I want it to map to. Now, if there's something you want to collect but isn't on this list here of fields you can map, for example, YouTube isn't in a question here. I want that information in my client's address book. I don't want to have to dig through all the different forms that they have to find where they told me their YouTube channel was. So what I'm going to do is create a custom map field. You'll go into the Settings tab, which is the cogwheel on the upper right. You will go to Custom Map Fields. It's toward the bottom. There are two types of custom mapped fields you can create here, and Dubsado gives you a little explanation of the types of mapped fields you can create. So if you choose a client mapped field, these are directly in the client's profile. They will follow the client on any project they are assigned to. The other option is job. Job custom map fields are tied only to the job profile and will not follow the client to any other jobs. So let me explain that to you. Inside of your projects tab, you have clients, and those clients have different projects you're working on or jobs that you're working on. Now, you could potentially have the same client come back to you for multiple jobs. So they could come to you in 2018, come back to you in 2019. You can choose whether or not you want this mapped field to follow them or not follow them based on if you choose client or job. In this scenario, I want to know their YouTube channel for any time they contact me. So I'm going to make that a client custom map field. So I will just hit create. And I'm going to give it a name. I'm going to call it YouTube. And then I have the option to choose if the kind of question I ask will be a short answer or a date. And obviously, this is going to be a short answer. And then I'll hit save. And then I'll go back into my lead capture in this case, add the field. So make sure you create the custom map field first and then go create it on the form. So I'm going to put the short answer because that's what I selected. And that goes to the bottom here. Okay, so I asked the question, what's your YouTube channel? And now I need to map my answer so that it pulls from the form and puts it in the address book. Now remember, I could create a custom app field or a job or a client. So I'm going to find YouTube under the client because that's where I created it. And at the very bottom here, I have YouTube. When a person fills out the lead capture on my website, it's going to ask them that question and then pull that information to their client profile and the address book. So let me just show you where it's going to go. It will go in utilities under address book, and it will go under the person's name. If you click on their name here, you can see all their contact details. It will also go inside of projects. So that person will end up in leads if they fill out my lead capture, and I'll just click on their name. And when they answer that question, the field right here will house their answer. I can see at a glance what their YouTube channel is. Otherwise, I would have to go into forms and dig through all these different forms here, open them up, and find where they put their YouTube channel. So that's the beauty of question mapping and custom mapped fields. And that's how you set up custom map fields. If you found this video helpful, make sure you give it a thumbs up and leave any comments you have down below so I can make sure to clarify things for you. My name is Ray. Thank you for stopping by my YouTube channel today. I'll see you around.